And now, Olivia, on to you now. You're standing by outside Singapore's embassy in Beijing. How are proceedings going?
Well, Julie, what we do know from the elections department is that there are over 6,600 Singaporeans living overseas that have registered to vote in this presidential election. And of that number, about a quarter of them, or around 1,600, live in mainland China, Hong Kong and Taiwan. And out of that number, many have chosen to vote by post for the first time that's being used this year, or at an overseas polling station, including where I am here in Beijing at the Singapore Embassy. Now, voting has been going on for a while now. There's been a steady trickle of people. Earlier on, we were inside the hall before proceedings began at 7:50 a.m. and we witnessed the ballot box being sealed by election officials. At 8 a.m. sharp, we saw the first voters streaming in to cast the first ballots here in Beijing in this presidential election. Now, even before the polls opened at 8 a.m., there was a queue of about 10 or so people outside the embassy, early voters wanting to get their ballot in before heading to work or going about their other activities. I spoke to one of these early voters who said that he felt that it was important for him to come in person to vote because he saw it as his duty. He also saw it as an opportunity to have his voice being heard as well. And people have been saying that proceedings have been pretty smooth. There's been a trickle of people. People have been able to get in and out, cast their vote in just a few minutes. But there are also those we have been speaking to who have chosen to cast their vote and to send in their vote by mail. This is the first time the postal ballot is being used in a Singapore election. People were saying that this was a convenient choice. It provided them an option to be able to vote, especially if they are living in a place where there is no overseas polling station. Many were not able to vote in the last general election back in 2020 due to COVID travel restrictions. And so they said they welcome this move of being able to send in their ballot by post, although some did encounter some challenges. Some said that when they were at the post office trying to send out their ballot, post office staff were not too familiar with the return envelope and they ended up having to pay a postage fee. But there were those who also said that this was a small price to pay in order to get their vote in for this election. Julie?
All right, Mary, thanks for getting up to speed with that. Olivia, let's move across to Michio, who's outside the Singapore Embassy in Tokyo. Michio, tell us about the situation there.
Yes, well, voting here in Tokyo started an hour earlier than in Singapore due to the time difference. Now, I've spotted about a dozen voters in 30 minutes since the polling box was opened. As of December 2022, there are 3,036 Singaporeans residing in Japan. That's according to the Japanese government statistics. Half of them live in Tokyo. And as a far third are in Kanagawa, and closely after that, Osaka. Now, that's in the order of the most populated prefectures in Japan. What Singaporeans here are doing for a living? Well, topping the list, 653 are in the intellectual sector or are in international business, and that's followed by exchange students. Now, I checked with the Singapore Ministry of Communications and Information on how many people in Japan are eligible to vote in this election. And at this point in time, they were unable to provide me with a figure, but I was able to talk to a few Singaporeans here. Those who have come to the embassy today told me that they're excited to be able to vote this time for a president, and they feel that it is a duty as a Singaporean to cast their ballot. But they also complain about the weather in Tokyo. There's a heat wave in Japan going on. In August, so we've experienced the hottest summer all over Japan, especially in Tokyo. It's reported that more than 20 days was over 35 degrees Celsius. And today, we're expecting a high of 35 degrees as well. But the Singapore Embassy says that they're providing air-conditioned room for the voters filters and also bottled water, so you know they can avoid those voters from being heat stroked. So this is the state in Tokyo.